Hi, so my name's Alexa Halford. I am at the Aerospace Corporation only just recently. I moved from Goddard, so this is nice to be back in a NASA kind of thing. I'm dyslexic, and if you know, dyslexics tend to flip concepts as well, and so they told me I had a massive screen and should have lots of really cool images, and so I said, let's play sound, because, you know, that works. One of the very first... Maybe going to move here in a second, or not. One of the very first discoveries of the space era was the radiation belts. It was the first thing we kind of got from Explorer, and it was named after the PI of that mission, James Van Allen. And one of the really cool things is that this ends up affecting a lot of our technology and our daily lives. And so we need to understand how these particles change in their variability. And one of the ways they do that is by interacting with waves in space. And these waves have actually been, we knew about them even before we knew about the radiation belts. And we used to identify them by listening to their sounds. They're actually in the radio frequency range, and so you can play it on a radio. And they sound kind of like this. Now, they've been referred to in the past as... they've been referred to in the past as space alien birds kind of things, because they actually work really, the analogy works really, really well. These waves actually occur on the dawn side of the Earth. So if you think of the sun is always there, we actually place ourselves around the Earth as a clock. So you have noon, midnight, dawn, and dusk. And those waves live most of the time over in this region. And so they sound like a dawn chorus of birds, which is really kind of cool. Now, the neat thing is that here at Earth, it's relatively easy to get to, and we can study these waves and learn all about how they interact with our radiation belts. But we are not the only planet to have radiation belts or these waves. We can listen to whistlers at Jupiter. Oops, maybe. You might have to click that. Thank you. Sorry for all of this. Whoops. I need to go back. There we go. Try it again. There we go. And you can kind of tell why they were named whistlers. They sound like whistling. Now, we find these kinds of waves at many different planets around our solar system, but it's not just the planets and the magnetospheres that have these wonderful sounds we can listen to. The sun also produces lots of radio waves, and type 3 radio bursts are really kind of a fun one. You might have to play that too. Yeah, sorry. Oh, there we go. Now, if you notice, this one's been, we cheated a bit. It's been sped up. You know, that's a few hours worth of time, and we played it in a couple of seconds. But still really neat. So we have all these sounds throughout our entire heliosphere. And it's only just recently that we've had anything go out beyond our heliosphere. I think everyone knows that Voyager and Pioneer are now outside of the sun's magnetic field, and we're for the first time traveling through interplanetary space. And so we can now hear the sounds from outside of our solar system. Whoops, we're gonna try it one more time. Oh, it should be there. There we go. So maybe in another, what, it took 30 odd years to get outside of the solar system. Maybe at some point we'll get outside of our galactic magnetic field, and we're going to be able to hear the sounds out beyond there. But it's really kind of neat how we're able to use these sounds to identify what's going on in our magnetosphere, what's going on in other magnetospheres, what's going on in the sun, and what's going on even outside of our own solar system. So thank you, and I'll take any questions you have. Sorry for not bringing prettier pictures and only bringing sounds. Any questions? I'm sure there's questions. I never explain anything that well. No? None? Come on. Okay, I can count on the Aussies in the back, right? We went to grad school at the same time, so I can pick on them, I'm sure. Okay. Well, thank you so much. Oh, sorry.
What do you want to hear next? What do you want to turn into sound that you haven't done yet?
Oh, I don't know. So many things. More waves. I like listening to the waves. And actually, I should do this. So you can actually find so many more sounds in space. Not just ones that sound like that. There's ones that sound like saucers. Ones that sound like hiss. If you were in the Upgoer 5 challenge, you heard me talking about angry space birds. And that was the chorus actually turning into hiss. So going from kind of happy sounding morning chorus to an angry bird inside of a cold, dense plasma. I think it's just, I like hearing the sounds of space. I know the guys at Iowa get a little tired of us playing them all the time, but you know, somebody made it a ringtone in our field and that apparently was pushing him over the edge. But yeah. Thanks. Thank you.